So today we are going to start our new topic, first topic of the subject, which is introduction to welding. Some part of this lecture will come in the midterm examination also. So please be careful regarding this lecture. In this lecture, we are going to talk about the classification of welding, basically how welding can be classified or subclassified into many other types. Okay. So before we move on to the classification of welding, first let's see what is welding. What is a welding process? So I will write the definition on the whiteboard for you guys. What is welding process? Okay. So welding is a process by which a localized permanent joint can be produced. Welding is a process by which a localized permanent joint can be produced. What does this mean? So we will figure out with the help of a diagram. In basic terms, or in basic layman language, welding is a process of joining two or more than two materials. A very simple definition. A process for joining two or more than two materials. I have got one material. Okay, I cannot join one material because I need another material to join it with. That is, a welding is a process of joining two or more than two materials. So it can be two, okay, it can be three also. Okay, so what does localized permanent joint means in the first definition? Okay, so we've got this, these two material. Okay, what does localized permanent joint means? So what does local means actually? Okay, so I've got this plate. Okay, if I talk about this plate as a whole, then this is whole plate. Okay, this is a whole plate. But if I talk about a specific place or a specific area, okay, then that is local place. So let's say I say I am only talking about this area only. Then this is local. Okay, a small portion in a whole plate is local. Let's say this surface is local surface. Okay, so if I'm going to mark this local area, then this is a local area. Okay, this is a whole area. This is a local area. So if I'm going to create a local joint only, so this part only and this small place only. So this local joint or local area, then this is called a localized permanent joint. Okay. So this is the definition of a local permanent joint. So welding is a process in which two or more than two materials are joined. Okay, so let's say I've got this material. This is plate one and this is plate number two. So I'm going to draw them. This is plate number one, P1. This is plate number two, P2. Okay, if this plate and this plate have same material. So this is made of aluminum, okay? This is also made of aluminum. So if these two material are same, or P1 and P2 are same, then this is called similar welding or similar materials welding. Today we have to learn about welding and classify welding based on different types. So one of the type based on material is basically similar welding. So based on material, so based on the material that I have to join, if the two materials are same or P1 is equals to P2, then this is called similar welding. So P1 is equals to plate number 2 is similar welding. Okay. If I'm going to join different materials, this is aluminium 7075. This is aluminium 6061, 6000 series. This is aluminium 7000 series. So these are different materials. So when I'm going to join different materials, a plate number 1 material is not equal to plate number 2 material, then this is called dissimilar materials welding. So P1 is not equals to P2. Then this is called dissimilar materials welding. So this was classification type number 1, C1. Classification type number 1. Okay. Now these two material or these two plates are also called parent material or base material. Okay, this material that I want to join, okay, this is also called parent material or base material. Okay. So this is also called base material. Or parent material. So there is a video for you guys to see about the introduction to welding. I have uploaded these slides on Kalam already. So you guys can go and download the slides and then watch the video. So let's move on to further classification of welding. This is a part of midterm question number 1. Okay, so this will come in midterm question number 1. I will ask you guys classify welding based on energy sources. Classify welding type based on materials to join. So I can ask you these types of question in the midterm. Now this is welding classification by state of metal. So this is based on state of metal. So you know that in physics there are 3 or 4 states of matter: solid, liquid, gas, and the 4th state is plasma. Okay. However, in welding we are only concerned with solid and liquid, or their combination, which is called solid liquid. Now how do we classify this? Let's have a look later on. So before we move on to this classification, let's look at this video. And I just want to show you the process of welding, okay? So you guys should visualize process of welding, okay? So this is a basically a torch, okay? Using this torch, they are going to melt the parent material or base material, and then by melting it will join, okay? So this is by melting, and this is by liquid state. So just go through these little bit of introduction on some videos. So this is basically arc welding, okay, in which I have got an electrode. This electrode is going to produce an arc, okay. Because of this arc, heat energy is created. Because of this heat energy, melting occurs. Because of melting, the two materials are joined. So we have got different types of heat sources. One is due to the gas. If this is a gas nozzle, then I'm going to use gas to melt the material. If I have got electric arc, then I can use electric arc, etc. So yeah, I think this is in general just to show you the pictures of welding. So if you are going to have different material, then this is called dissimilar welding, okay? Aluminium and steel, then this is dissimilar materials welding. Welding dissimilar materials. It's quite complex phenomena, and sometimes we have to add filler material in between to adjust the difference in alloying, okay? So anyways, let's move on to welding classification based on state of matter. So welding can be classified either by liquid, solid, or liquid, solid, or solid, liquid. So number one is liquid. Okay. What does this liquid mean? Okay. If I'm going to melt the parent material, this parent material, and this parent material, P2, I apply some amount of heat. Because of this heat, the parent material becomes liquid. Okay, and then they mix together. So they melt first, become melt, then become liquid. Then they mix, and because of mixing, when they cool, a joint is created. Okay, so I am going to apply heat energy to melt the material. Because of melting, they will become liquid. Because of liquid, they will mix together. Okay, because this is liquid, so locally it will mix together. Okay, that is why it is local joint. So locally it is going to mix in this area, and then after the mixing it is going to cool down. After cooling down, it is going to become a permanent single plate or a single joint. So this is liquid state welding. Okay, now what is solid state welding? So here I am applying heat energy. In the liquid state, I am applying heat energy. Okay. Now, in the solid state, what happens? I have got parent material or base material. This is parent material number one. This is parent material number two. Okay. What is going to happen is I am going to apply pressure. Okay, so I am going to apply pressure force. So I am not going to apply heat now, I am going to apply severe plastic deformation pressure. Okay, like this. Okay. Then I'm going to rub them together very quickly. So I'm doing pressurizing also and rubbing together. Because of that, some heat is produced, okay? And the material is going to become red hot or plastic. Once it becomes red hot or plastic, then it is going to mix together. Okay? So this is solid state welding. How does this happen? Let's visualize this first. To understand solid state welding, let us visualize it first, how this occurs. Okay? So let me show you an example of solid state welding. So I've got two material. I'm applying pressure and then rubbing them. Because of rubbing, heat is produced and materials does not melt, or it only becomes plastic. So you can see it is only becoming plastic, red hot only. It's kind of a gooey state. You can see that we are not externally providing heat. The heat is generated because of the pressure itself. So this is a plastic state. Okay. After that, it is going to cool down. So here you can see a joint is created. It is now cooling down. Okay. So what happens in solid state? We apply pressure. Because of this pressure, what happened here? The material, then some heat is also produced. Some heat is also produced. Because of that heat and pressure, both material become plastic or semi-plastic. So it is plastic or semi-plastic. After the material becomes plastic or semi-plastic, they become fused together. So because of this plastic, they fuse together. Then they cool down. And then it joins. Okay, so this is the process of solid state welding where pressure is applied. Notice that you have got this excess material outside. Okay, this excess material is called flash, and that flash can be removed later on by machining process. Okay, so flash or burrs are produced that can be removed by a machining process. So this, to understand solid state welding, it was important to watch this video. To understand liquid state welding, which we have just seen, let's have a look at the video also. What is liquid and how much melting occurs? So here, as an example, you are going to see an arc welding process. Okay, here you can see that the base material is melted also. Okay, and then the filler material is melting also. That I will talk about later. But just see that this is all liquid. Okay, the whole material, this is metal, actually molten metal, very hot. So the whole material has melted, and if you can see this. Orange, sorry, purple. This purple area, this is basically an electric arc. Okay, it is an electric arc. That electric arc produces heat energy. So, this is liquid state welding. And there is another. So we have covered solid state welding, we have covered liquid state welding. Then there is another one which is called solid liquid welding. Okay. So type number three is solid liquid वर्ल्ड। बिफोर वी मूव ऑन टू सॉलिड लिक्विड वेल्डिंग, यू शुड नो दैट वेल्डिंग कैन बी कैरीड आउट विद फिलर और विदाउट फिलर। ओके, वेल्डिंग कैन बी कैरीड आउट विद फिलर और विदाउट फिलर। What does this means? If I have got parent material, and this is parent material too, and I put another material in between, okay. I'm going to put another material in between. This is called filler material. So with the help of an intermediate or another material in between, if I am going to do welding, then this is called filler material based welding. So this is filler material. This is filler material. Okay. So we have got now two types of another welding. One without filler material, in which I only melt the parent material. So I have got this plate P1 and P2. I am not basically using any filler material. So the welding in which filler material is not used is called autogenous welding. There is no filler material here. So welding in which filler material is not used is called autogenous welding. And the welding at which filler material is used is called filler material based welding. Now, filler based material welding has two types. Now, this filler material based welding has two types. Homogeneous and heterogeneous. And heterogeneous. What does homogeneous and heterogeneous means? Obviously, it means that filler material is going to be used. So this is plate number one or parent material number one. The filler material is same as parent material number one also. So, or two. So this is filler material and this is parent material number two. And this is filler material. If filler material and parent material are made of the same material, so material of P1 is equals to filler material is equals to P2, then this is called homogeneous welding. All materials are homogeneous. So this is plate number one. Okay. Then I have got my filler material. Then this is plate number two. So you can see that all the materials are same. Okay. The filler material is also same as the parent material. Then this is called homogeneous welding. And in heterogeneous welding, if I am going to put, let's say, This is another type of filler material in between. Okay. So now I have got two materials, parent materials, which are same, but filler material is different. Okay. Then this is called heterogeneous welding. Heterogeneous welding. So for heterogeneous welding, this is plate number one, a parent material or base material. Then the filler material is different. This is filler material, which is different. And then you got parent material number two. So parent material number one is equals to parent material number two, but they are both are not equal to the filler material. Okay, then this is called heterogeneous welding. How a filler material is added? Here in this video, you can see also. That you can see this is a filler rod and material is being added into the molten pool. So filler material is added between the localized area where I am going to do the melting process. Okay, so filler material is added during the welding process. So what is solid liquid welding? Solid liquid welding means that my parent material is solid, okay, but I am only going to basically melt my filler material. So this is the filler material. I am only going to melt the filler material in between solid material. Okay, it means that the plates or the parent material are solid, and the filler material I'm going to melt is going to be liquid. So this is solid, this is liquid, that is why it is called solid liquid welding. Okay, so we move back. So solid with liquid welding is related to filler material. Okay, so solid liquid welding is related to filler material. Okay, it means that my parent material P1 and P2, they both are solid. Okay, and I'm going to put a filler material, liquid filler material inside. This is liquid. Okay, so this is called solid liquid. This is called solid liquid joining or welding. Now students will ask this question, that in this video, what is the state? Okay, I will say that the state is liquid welding. Why? Because the parent material is melted already. You can see this portion area. The parent material is also melted and the filler material is also melted. So both of them have melted actually. So it's basically liquid welding. Whereas in this figure or in this video, you can see that nothing melted. So this is an example of solid welding. So this was all about solid liquid and solid liquid and solid liquid, solid slash liquid welding process. Just one slide. So let's move on to classification of joining process. Okay. So the reason why these slides are important, because they are a part of midterm. So I will ask you guys, classify welding process based on the type of filler, classify welding process based on the states of matter, classify welding process based on the energy provided, something like that. So here you can see we've got joining process. In joining process, we've got mechanical bonding, let's say screw, rivets, fasteners. Okay, they are permanent, they are basically temporary or semi-permanent joints. You can remove the joint later on. Okay, so screws and rivets can be removed later on, but welding is a permanent localized deformation. It cannot be removed later on. Okay, now joining process, mechanical bonding is, you see rivets, stitches, staples, screw. This is a separate topic, manufacturing topic. We are only related to welding process. Welding process is a part of atomic bonding. Why it is a part of atomic bonding? Because basically when you melt a material, okay, this is parent material number 2, parent material number 3, then on atomic level, the atoms move from one material to another material. They transport, they diffuse, they move, they mix at atomic scale or an atomic level. That's why it is called atomic bonding. So here you can see welding has got solid state, liquid state, and solid liquid state. Now these are further classification: friction welding, diffusion welding, hot forge welding for the solid state. Just now in the video which we saw for the solid welding, this one was friction welding actually. Okay, now in the liquid state, just now we saw the video, it was electric arc welding, electric and then arc welding. Okay, and then solid liquid welding is something separate, like soldering, where you got a solder plate, a plate, and then you put a lead solder ball. So you only melt the lead only, you don't melt the plate in the soldering process. So these are basically the types of welding based on states. So as we saw in welding, we can either apply heat energy, okay, that heat energy can be due to electricity, photon, laser, or chemical energy. So if you've got a plate, okay, and you are putting laser beam energy, okay, this is a laser going on, then laser is basically photon, okay, they are photons. You can also do EBW, which is electrons. So this is type of energy for heat energy is photon. Then you can also apply electric arc. So I've got an electrode. Okay, this electrode which you see normally in the welding shops, it produces electric arc. Okay, this arc basically produces heat energy. And then we've got chemical energy as well. Then we've got pressure welding, okay, like we have forge welding, friction welding, just now you saw in the video. So that is pressure and then that is heat. And then sometimes you can apply both heat and pressure. So what happens is that you are applying pressure also, you are applying pressure also, and then applying heat also together. So this is both pressure and heat are applied. So they are basically hybrid joining processes. And resistance welding basically is a process in which both heat and pressure is applied. This is something which we will learn later on in the types of fusion welding processes. So next, move to classification of welding video. Okay, so welding process here, so as I told you guys, welding can be classified in many types. Okay, so that is why some people classify based on heat, pressure, liquid state, solid state, autogenous, non-autogenous, what is the type of end position, so something like that. So anyway, if you go through the video, you will learn further more about the types of welding. Okay, so here in this video, they are talking about the heat and pressure. Okay, then they are talking about fusion and pressure. Once again, it is the same. Okay, this is an arc welding process. Okay, which is being carried out. Heat energy is provided. Okay, the parent material is also melting. Okay, then you've got a filler rod. Okay, that filler rod is also melting. So this is liquid state fusion welding. Okay. So this is a welding torch. This is a filler rod. These are, this is an arc which is produced, and this is the molten metal or liquid form of metal. This is fusion welding. What is pressure welding? So basically, they apply pressure. Okay, a mechanical force is applied to join the material along with heat energy. So this creates a very strong joint also. So there are different types of fusion welding and there are different types of pressure welding. So go through the video and you will learn the concept in a better way. And there are definitions also. Now we classify welding based on energy. Okay. Classification of welding based on C, I think 3, based on energy. Okay, so here you can see electrical energy, chemical energy, mechanical energy, and light or energy beam energy. Light energy or energy beam. Okay. So in the light energy, we've got laser welding. Okay, we have got laser brazing, and then we also have electron beam welding. Okay, EBW. If we talk about energy rays, then in the mechanical, we have got riveting and bolting. This is not a part of welding. This is a part of joining process only. If we talk about welding only, this is the welding portion. Okay. This is the welding portion. Okay. So if we talk about mechanical, then we have friction welding. Friction welding is basically applying pressure and friction. So this is a part of mechanical energy. Then chemical energy can be applied also using gas, using explosion welding, flame blazing. Then electrical energy can be provided with the help of arc, okay, or soldering. Electron beam welding is also, they are saying it is a part of electrical energy, but I think it is more on energy rays. So it is a type of energy rays. Anyways, you guys can put it under electrical energy also, it is possible. Then you've got resistance welding, flash welding, etc. So you can see that welding can be classified based on four types of energies. Remember this. This is a part of midterm question. Okay. So we have already covered that joining process. If it is, so this is another classification of welding, a larger classification. Okay. We have got metallurgical bonding, which occurs during welding, okay. Then we've got fusion welding, pressure welding once again, brazing, soldering, and anti-fusion welding. This is solid liquid welding, okay, this part. So fusion welding has got gas, arc, etc. So different types of welding can be classified under different categories. So I have put a video for you guys to look at a very unique process called explosion welding, in which basically we do an explosion between two sheets, above a sheet. So I've got sheet number one, then I've got sheet number two, and I'm going to do explosion on the top of sheet number one, and this causes that sheet to join very firmly with the sheet. Okay. So here if you can see, this is, there are two plates. I want to join two plates together on this surface, the larger surface. Okay. So we can have a lot of combinations of metals. Okay. So first process is basically we grind the surface and clean the surface. Okay. Using a surface grinder. Now the first plate is called backer plate and the upper plate is called cladding plate. And now they are going to put detonation on top. Explosion is occurring on top. So explosion is occurring on top. Okay. And then a joint is produced because of the pressure. Okay. So this is a very unique process of explosion welding. Here you can see two different parts are joined. Two different plates are joined together. So So explosion welding is quite unique. Okay, so it is very not commonly used. So classification based on energy, there were four classification, right? Electrical energy, chemical energy, mechanical energy, and light energy or energy beams. Okay, this is classification based on energy. Now, there is a society in welding which is called American Welding Society, AWS. Okay, AWS is called American Welding Society. American Welding Society also classify welding based on different types. Okay, so they classify welding based on the gas, based on arc, based on resistance welding, based on solid state welding process, and based on unique process. Okay, so different societies also can classify welding differently. So American Welding Society is an international society, and that society produces regulations and procedures regarding these types of welding. So they are going to say that, okay, oxy fuel welding should be carried out under these circumstances. The joint should be clean, the joint should be well prepared, the chamfering angle should be like this, then the environment should be blinded. So they have got guidelines for different types of welding. So American Society, Welding Society, is basically a society that produces guidelines, procedures, rules for doing welding or different types of welding. So then we've got another type based on filler material that we have learned already. Okay, so just now I told you we've got autogenous welding, in which parent materials are welded and there is no filler material. Okay, then we've got homogeneous welding, and then we've got heterogeneous welding, in which the filler material is different than the parent material. Before we move on to why welding is important, I want to also show you another type, which is depending on mechanism. Classification based on mechanism. What does classification based on mechanism means? It is basically either manual, it is semi-automatic, and then we have got fully automatic. What is manual welding? So I have got plate number two. I got plate number one together. I'm using my hand. Okay, this is the electrode plus filler, and I am manually doing welding. Sorry for the noise, guys. Some work is in progress. Sorry for that. So manual is I'm manually doing the welding. Okay, what is automatic or semi-automatic? So I have got a machine, and that machine is basically doing the welding process automatically, a robotic arm or something. What is semi? It means that I am giving the heat automatic, but I am doing the filler manually. Okay, so semi-automatic is that some portion is automatic, some portion is non-automatic. So manual is basically purely entirely by hand. Okay, usually the welders which you see in the shops, they are doing manual or welding. Now, another classification is based on the position one, actually. So number six is based on position. So what does this mean? This is downward or flat position. This is horizontal. Okay guys, so what is based on position? So if I have got a different position, okay, let's say this one horizontal. So this plate is horizontal. Okay, I am standing like this and then I am doing the welding. Then this is horizontal position. This is entirely vertical. So vertical down means from top going down, and vertical upward means from bottom going upwards. Okay, and then this is overhead welding. Okay, doing overhead welding from below. Okay, so these are welding based on positions. Okay, so one is downward flat. So I'm doing the welding downward flat. Then I'm doing the welding horizontal. Then I'm going vertical down. So from top I'm going down. Or vertical up, from bottom I am going upwards. And then overhead welding. I am going from bottom. So doing the welding from below. Okay, so I am doing the welding from below. So this is welding based on positions. So why welding is important? It is important because we cannot manufacture everything in a single piece. A car is around 50 to 100,000 pieces. So we have to join those pieces together somehow. Many products are cheaper to fabricate as many individual components and then we can join later. So sometimes what happens is that I can make this component by drawing process. I can make this component by cutting process and then I can join these together. So this is the reason why welding is important. What are the advantages and disadvantages? Simple joint can be produced. Welding have very high strength. So when I'm going to do welding, then they have got very, very high strength actually. They produce seals. So when you do welding process, basically you are creating a seal also. Okay, so you are creating a waterproof seal. It is leak proof. You can join thickness of 1 millimeter to 200 millimeter. So it can be very thin. So this is a plate which is very thin and this is a plate which is very thick. So you can join these different thickness of material also. I forgot to show you guys. This is an example of an arc welding. Here you can see the parent material number one, parent material number two, and this is the weld or melted filler material. Okay, this is the melted filler material. Here you can see I have added some additional material inside. Okay, now if the parent material has also melted, okay, and the filler material has also melted, so this is a type of liquid state welding. Okay, now this one is I have used a filler material. Okay, if we are going to use filler material and this is the same type of filler material, okay, then this is called homogeneous welding. But you can see that this is different material. This is 6061 aluminium 6061 and this is 7075. So this is dissimilar welding. Dissimilar welding using a common filler material. Okay, so I think this can be this filler material matches maybe this one, but does not matches this one. That is why it is heterogeneous, because the filler material does not matches the parent material. Okay, should be like this because both of them are dissimilar material. So this is a this is basically an example of a liquid state welding. So this is dissimilar welding, liquid state fusion welding, and heterogeneous filler material or heterogeneous welding also. So this is a plate, and you can see this plate has distorted. If you can see, so this plate has got now an angle. Okay, this angle is distortion angle. So welding, one of the disadvantages of welding, you see this distortion, this plate has bent actually because of the thermal forces and because of the residual forces. Even if I want to bend it, I cannot bend it back. It is very strong distortion. So this angular distortion, okay, can occur during the welding process. That is why during the welding process, we have to clamp the material very tightly before welding. And after, before, during welding, then we do this welding process. So this is called, this is distortion actually happening. So distortion occurs due to residual stresses, okay? There are many imperfections in welding. So if you can see imperfections, you can see there is some melt material here, a defect called splatter or spatter, okay? You can see a blackish area. This, there is blackish area called slag also. So there are various imperfections. It is not very continuous. There are imperfections. Okay. Below here, you can see some melted material coming out also. So there are some imperfections in the welding process. It is very difficult to weld dissimilar material, and it depends on the welding operator skills. So this is an example of solid state welding, in which I did not do the welding, but I only do plastic deformation by friction strip. So using friction strip, I basically mixed these two material by plasticizing them, okay? So this is a basically an example of solid state welding. So this is it, guys. So this is a midterm, okay? Have a look. So based on ASME classification of welding techniques, okay, so we go back to ASME. So these are ASME types of welding. List down three welding techniques for each scenario and where applicable, rank them. So three different categories of states of matter or atomic bonding. So you go back to state of matter. State of matter, so solid state, liquid state, and liquid solid state, and then write the category name. So friction welding, electric arc welding, and brazing. This is the correct answer. Then classify welding based on autogenous welding. It means does not require any filler material. So you can choose anyone, any classification based on filler material. So this one does not use filler material, okay? Forge welding, beast welding does not use filler material. So choose any three of them, up to you. Then based on the type of energy utilized, so you go back to the type of energy slide. Okay? This is the type of energy, electrical energy, you should put arc welding. Then type of energy, chemical energy, put explosion welding. Then mechanical energy, put friction welding. So you should know about this classification. So